Galaxy A51's camera comes with a pro mode and we are about to find out how good it is. Take a look at the normal camera mode first. As you can see, you can access the ultrawide camera and all other accessible options are visible on the screen. When we switch to the pro mode, we lose the ability to use the ultrawide camera first of all. The 48 megapixels mode is still accessible here. Let's take a look at the settings in the pro mode now. You can see that pretty much all the options are faded out. You can change the video resolution, but we cannot record the videos in the pro mode. We do have the option to enable the grid lines too. We cannot save the pictures in the raw format. Take a look at the pro mode now. We have only three options here. The first one is the ISO. This is your sensor's sensitivity to light. Lower the ISO means lower the sensitivity and vice versa. In simple words, the lower ISO is used when the light conditions are very good, but when you are shooting in the low light, you may consider raising the ISO. The maximum ISO in the pro mode of the A51 is 800, but remember that when you are taking pictures in the normal or the automatic camera mode, the ISO goes up to 2000. Another thing that you must remember is that the higher the ISO, the more grainy your picture will be. The ISO in the pro mode can be set to automatic or manual depending on your choice. So when the light conditions are very good outside, especially when you are shooting in the daylight, you should use the minimum possible ISO, which is 100 in the pro mode, and in the normal or automatic mode, it can go as low as 50. Next is the white balance. This is basically the color temperature, or as they call it, it is the process of removing the unrealistic colors from your picture. It's set to a particular value by default, which is usually the 5500 Kelvin. But if you go downward, it will make your picture look cool, and going upward will add a warm effect. Depending on the environment you are shooting in, and depending on what color temperature you want, you can set the white balance. If you're not sure how to use a white balance properly, you can set it to auto as well. The last option is the exposure. This is the amount of light that reaches your camera's sensor. In simple words, it defines how bright or dark your picture is going to be. It works in a similar manner to the ISO. Lower the exposure, the darker the picture will be, and higher the exposure, the brighter the picture will be. Other than these options, you have the timer, the metering options are there for better focus, and the resolution options can be selected manually. In the pro mode, you can zoom in or zoom out in the 3:4 mode only. The 48 megapixels mode is pretty much restricted to a few limited options only. As I change the ISO, the white balance and the exposure, you can see how it changes the picture that I am about to capture right now. Now I am going to show you the side-by-side pictures taken in the normal photo mode and in the pro mode. In the left picture, the ISO is 50, but in the picture on the right side, the ISO is 100 because the pro mode did not have an option to go to 50. Also, the white balance was set to auto while the exposure was normal, but the picture appears to be a bit dark as compared to the automatic picture. I think raising the exposure slightly would have helped. However, the auto mode picture appears to have great details and overall color tone. Take a look at another picture. The auto mode picture once again has better details, the sharpness and the overall tone. I did try taking many other pictures and all of them lost details just like this one. In the night mode, this phone's auto mode went up to 2000 ISO and the picture was super bright. However, I had only 800 max ISO and limited exposure once again for the pro mode. Here is how the pro mode's picture at the night came out. With the 800 ISO, the maximum exposure and 2900 Kelvin white balance. I tried changing the settings, but I could not take a picture as bright as the phone's night mode. So in the end, I concluded that sticking to the automatic mode of the Galaxy A51 is probably the best choice. Back in the day, Samsung was not adding pro mode to its mid-range phones, Now that it has finally started adding, I believe it will slowly improve it too. Right now, the Pro Mode's functionality is very limited. Maybe it's only good for low light photography, but this phone's sensor is good for low light photography anyway. Personally, I would have loved having the shutter speed and the aperture settings, especially for those long exposure shots, but we do need to understand that this phone does not have a flagship grade camera and it's going to have a limited functionality. Also, I am not a very good photographer. If you are a photography expert, please drop your feedback in the comment section below recording how you can make the best use of these limited settings. With that said, I will now sign off. Make sure to subscribe and hit the like button. I will see you in the next one really soon.